I think his inner circle probably has the reins on power. The military is the most powerful institution in the country, but the momentum is on the side of the people. And you've seen a real shift over the past week. Mubarak has twice tried to get out there, giving speech, mobilizing public sentiment. The first time it helped a little bit. This time, I think he has blown it.
I think you look great today. I'm absolutely convinced that Omar Suleiman, together with the chief of staff of the military, are the two most important people in Egypt right now. That's, his name is Sami Anan. He's the chief of staff of the military. He controls the actual military apparatus in that country. The defense minister, the defense minister Tantwani, is going to be brushed aside, in my judgment, although he has went down to the demonstrators to basically show his face. But Omar Suleiman has been
an... Okay, you make an argument, but it's an argument until I see before I top him. Why is he still the titular head of that country? Why is he still Mr. President?
Well, I'm convinced it almost has little to do, believe it or not, with what's taking place inside Egypt, as much as his presence has to do with the other Arab allies of Egypt who fear that he was the firewall between them and the demonstrators.
What good does it do them to have him keep the title, not the power?
Because it doesn't create the impression that to the other potential demonstrators in their own countries that they can send their own leaders packing on a plane to either Saudi Arabia or elsewhere.
Oh, so they're afraid that exile looks too inviting for the people of their countries.
That's right. Yeah.
What is it in the Middle Eastern culture? And you've been a reporter over there. In our country, if you don't like, say, Richard Nixon, you send him on a plane to California. He goes lives in San Clemente. Not a bad place to go, actually. Or Jimmy Carter, if you beat him for re-election, he goes down to Plains, Georgia. There's something in the Arab or in Islamic culture. He's got to get out of the country. What is this about exile? Is this an old banishment thing from the caravan? If you're bad, we send you away. Why do they want him to leave?
It doesn't have anything to do
with it. He's got $80 billion. Yeah. Why would he want to leave? I don't know.
Well, he feels Egyptian, and not only that, he feels he is Egypt.
Doing better now?
So we're headed back towards a chance of some rain tonight, and that's not really an issue. It will be cold again, somewhere near freezing for most folks or below, and then highs tomorrow should actually be maybe just a touch warmer than today, maybe up to 40s, about 50 degrees. Increasing clouds, increasing chance of rain by tomorrow night. Up in the Cascades, 4500 feet on the snow level after the Cascades.
the weekend, in the first part of next week, snow will be a factor for your travels in the mountain passes, so you just want to keep that in mind. East of the mountains, mid-40s to the north and to the south, and as a matter of fact, it'll be about 50 degrees in the Tri-Cities and Walla Walla. Spokane goes 42, 44 in Pullman. Here's what's happening nationally. There are actually some signs that temperatures are beginning to moderate a little bit. We're finding that areas like North Texas and Oklahoma, some of these places that have been below freezing for the daytime highs are now actually above that mark. It is still really cold and around the Great Lakes region and the Northeast, but at least the daytime highs have come up out of the single digits. Yeah. All right, here's your five-day temperature trend for around here. You can see as we go into the weekend, we start to just drop up a little bit, especially in that Sunday, Monday time frame. Increase in clouds tomorrow, and we're back to the February that we know and love. Yeah, it's coming back. All right, they have it back to you for now. Let's see about the question.
Oh, today's question. All right, according to a new study, men are twice as likely to do this in the first week of dating someone than women are. Have you consulted
with Rachel? Well, yeah, we've discussed it here, and we still think it's something to do. It doesn't have to necessarily be not call back, just not follow through. That's it.
Just not following through in general?
Yeah, just in general, that's it.
The answer is very romantic. Say I love you. Men are twice as likely to say I love you.
Are you kidding me? Really?
Than women, yeah. Who knew? Well, Cody from Mount Vernon knew. That's what he knew.
Wow.
Well done, Cody.
There's some guys that are going, what?
Jaws dropping?
What?
Yeah, now we all know. Twice as likely. All right, we'll see you in five, Steve.
Okay, back to you.
Now today's problem solvers report. We're going to tell you how to whiten your teeth. But first, some new numbers out today on housing. Consumer problem solver, advice about this year. We'll call it that.
And we're not moving in the direction we would like to, unfortunately. Our state's housing market continues to struggle. Sales of existing homes last quarter ended 21% lower than in the final 3 months of 2009. Most of that drop is attributed to the end of special federal tax credits. The median sales price in our state is also down 2%. It's now $239,000 statewide. That is the lowest fourth quarter since 2004. And speaking of averages, the average rate for a 30-year fixed loan topped 5% this week. That is the first time it's happened since April. Rates are following the yields on the 10-year Treasury note, which are spiking on fears of higher inflation. Higher rates could further hamper the struggling housing market ahead of the spring primetime buying season. Also today, looking to add some sparkle to your smile? So he or she says, I love you when you go out on that date. Well, the biggest smile booster, bar none, is white teeth. The folks at Good Housekeeping have some advice on the best ways to whiten teeth without spending thousands of dollars at the dentist office. Teeth whitening products you use at home have gotten much more effective and less abrasive, according to Vino Aral, Health, Beauty, and Environmental Sciences Director at the Good Housekeeping Research Institute.
We have found that you can use inexpensive products at home to whiten your teeth, and they dissolve at the fraction of the cost of big office treatments. Products we like include Crest New Nice Strips, which you can use to whiten your teeth in just 2 hours. Another product we like is Colgate's Total Advanced Whitening Gel, which you can use every day to maintain whiter teeth. Here at the Good Housekeeping Research Institute, we recently tested a unique product. The Gold Smile Whitening Light, it promises to lighten teeth up to 6 shades in just one session. We found that it lightened our volunteers' teeth an average of 1.6 shades. While that was less than promised, our volunteers liked the amount of whitening and the speed of the process.
And if you would like to know more about these teeth whitening products, you can find out about them on our website. Just go to comonews.com.
A light, huh? Mm-hmm. Interesting. Thank you.
Great idea, huh?
Very much.
Sorry. Okay.
A look at what's moving the markets today. After the break.
tradition now. Is that alright? Are you comfy? Mm-hmm.